Welcome to Facts TV News, where everything is true. Police sergeant found dead in parked vehicle in St. Elizabeth. The body of a police sergeant was found on Saturday morning, slumped over the steering wheel of his vehicle in Goshen, St. Elizabeth. He has been identified as Lindsay Simmet, who was about 51 years old. Available information indicated that Simmet was on protracted sick leave and was last heard from on Thursday. It is believed that he was under investigation by the police force for alleged misappropriation of funds, and as a result, he became depressed and somewhat withdrawn. His body was found with what appeared to be a gunshot wound to his left ear. The vehicle was parked on a dirt road in a wooded area of the main road in the Goshen area. Portland farmer shot dead tending to cows in neighboring St. Thomas. A Portland farmer was shot dead on Sunday morning in the neighboring parish of St. Thomas. The deceased has been identified as 54-year-old Vivian Johnson, popularly known as CJ. Reports are that about 9 a.m., the farmer, who was from Hectors River in Portland, went to tend to his cows on a section of the bordering parish. It is believed that in the process he encountered men stealing his cows and was subsequently shot several times. The Golden Grove police are conducting an investigation into the development. Selector Fire Ross house shot up in Newlands. Popular dancehall selector Fire Ross is now living in fear that his mother may be harmed by gunmen. This after his childhood home in Newlands, Portmore, St. Catherine, was shot up by a group of heavily armed men on Wednesday night. It happened at about 8 p.m. on Wednesday. I wasn't there. I was on the road with an artist. But the gunmen came and shut up my house with my mother and my grandmother in it, the selector, whose real name is Shalako Allen, reported. Fire Ross claims the police, despite being believed to be aware of the identities of the attackers, have not acted decisively in relation to the development, even though they saw the damage to his house during their investigations. He said he reported the matter to the St. Catherine Sound Divisional Headquarters in Portmore. The police have the information since Thursday morning, but we had to go back to the police on Saturday to make another report because the police are not acting. And not only that, they are terrorizing our family, he claimed. They have now locked up my brother and are threatening to lock me up because. Essentially, he said the attackers had organized to send people to the police station to file reports that he and his brother had been firing guns on them. Allen said he has moved his grandmother out of the community, but his mother refuses to leave. It is our land, but there are people who want it. That's why the community is saying it is a land war. But if it is a land war, them have to bring it to my auntie. My only business with a piece of the land, the selector added. This thing is that on, laying everybody is against me, including my family and my neighbors. That's why me think is a land war for real, he elaborated. He is concerned about the safety of his mother. I moved my grandmother, but my mother said she is not moving. She sleep in there with the broken glass same way. My family is under threat. The police them lock up my brother. In January, them say boy a fire shot around and made them turn round and make a report to the police. When police bring me go station, question and let me go, and a 16-year-old boy go station, go lodge report who I have never seen yet. He claimed a shot glazed him and his shirt never burned up and his skin wasn't scarred. So the police dismissed the evidence and dropped me back at my house, Ross reported. He said the same day he discovered that two of his car tires were also slashed. He claimed that no action was taken by the police regarding that matter. Then he said the situation escalated dramatically this week, 5 months later. Away the police dem a pressure. And our house get damaged, but the police them a say a who a report most, and for them story, them a work offer. How that is possible? Them a take reports, now when me simple can investigate and see who the perpetrators are. What them want me fi do? Make up report to? How me fi make up a report to the police station if there's nothing to make a report on? Them people they depend your name every day at the station. My brother is a mason, I am a studio. My mother and my grandmother almost got shot on Wednesday night. The whole house got shut up. 5 windows got shut out and no justice, and upset Fire Ross claimed. He said he is also concerned that he may be detained because of the constant allegations being made against him. If I never stand up strong, I would be in police custody right now. Them reports say me fire shot, and them reports say me are done, yet I am doing the right thing. It took 5 hours yesterday just for the police to take my mother's statement. This is why people say there is no justice in Jamaica, he stated. This here's a wicked people debout, but me never see it yet. Things happen, with some people do things, and we say they should not go on, but this proves the wicked people they on earth in a real life, said Allen. Fire Ross earned his name as a selector from Stone Love Movements and is known for his popular high-energy mixtapes. He is also known for his charitable work in Portmore through his Fire Ross Foundation that helped to feed people during the COVID-19 pandemic last year. He has also produced songs such as Make It Out by upcoming artist Legacy. Man jail for smuggling cocaine worth $88 million in veggie chunks from Jamaica. A man who attempted to smuggle cocaine worth £420,000 in veggie chunk from Jamaica into the United Kingdom, UK over 2 years ago has picked up a 9-year prison sentence for his efforts. Horace Thompson, a 50-year-old resident of Witton, Birmingham in the UK, was sentenced on Friday for importation of Class A drugs into Britain. He was found guilty after a 5-day trial in the Birmingham Crown Court. Thompson was arrested following a search of his bags when he arrived at the Birmingham airport from Montego Bay, Jamaica on June 17, 2018, the Birmingham Mail newspaper reported. When Border Force officers searched his bags, they found 5.2 kilograms of high-purity cocaine inside bags of veggie chunks from Jamaica. The newspaper reported that closer analysis of the drugs revealed that it had a high purity of 63% of cocaine. This would be worth £420,480, approximately 88.7 million Jamaican dollars, once cut and sold on the street level, National Crime Agency forensic expert in the UK reported. Thompson denied packing the drugs that were in his suitcase, claiming that he had been used as an unwitting mule. However, he was convicted on the drug charges. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, and click the notification bell for daily updates.